Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Fallout 3. As per usual, we're just going to go ahead and jump right on in here. And ideally, you know, it's not going to be too terrible. I do expect some plot exposition, but, you know, hey, whatever. I'm hoping this episode doesn't go up late. Our modem is on the fritz, and I think it's going to die. But, you know, ideally, it'll last. I'd rather not have to make a trip to Best Buy to buy one when I can just get one on Amazon, but... Alright, I do want to poke around here before we go in there. I want to see if there's anything worthwhile. Excuse me. Man, clearing my throat right at the start here. We got some tribals, which I've been shooting. Some fruits. What's the difference? Wild punga. Punga fruit plant. Alright. I'm sure they both just give me punga fruits. It's just for some reason the devs decided to differentiate. And you know, I guess if that's what they want to do, more power to them. Alright, well, I guess let's go on in here and see what's what. How bad could it be? Man, they've got like these little growth things going on. It reminds me of RimWorld. A bunch of yeast, which I actually need. Can't remember how many though. 3 bags of yeast. Okay, so we have enough of those then, I believe. Miscellaneous. Yes. Yeah, 4. Alright, and 6 fission batteries, which I think we have like 3 or 2. 3, yeah. So I'm gonna have to keep my eye out for those. Maybe we can burgle some while we're here. Might as well look around a little, I guess. They don't seem to mind, so. Some cameras. Wonder glue and a sensor module. I'm not gonna loot everything because this is like these people's homes and Devon wouldn't do that. You know, he'll gank a fission battery and some yeast here or there, but I'm not gonna take like all of their stuff. A neatly stacked pile of books that I must ruin. Empty suitcase, yeast. No, I thought I saw one. I thought I saw a fission. I did. Alright, that's 4 fission batteries. And that looks like about it in there. Okay.
Transcend.
Freaking, bleh, like doped out tribal.
To the mind.
And you as well.
They're like freaking out, and that one just
transcend.
Thank you.
Weird. Nadine staring at a corner there. More power to you. Hey, like I said, I am going to poke around before I do any talking here, see if I can't find- Oh, hello! I will take a stealth boy. I will take some rat away, and I guess some rat X, because why not? Oh, there's the refined punga fruits. Which I'm not really too particularly interested in. And that just got some cram and water in it, and this has some relaxed wear. Stimpak. Moonshine, rat away. There's hiding stuff everywhere. Okay, so let's talk to Jimson. Where is he? I just saw him. There he is.
Pardon me while I commune with the higher planes.
Clear.
Something troubles you?
Okay, where can I find Jackson?
Alas, only the worthy may enter his nexus of meditation. He has not seen fit to enlighten me.
Alright.
Be well.
Clear your mind, child. Mind at peace.
What about yes, you? Mother.
Looks like another newbie in the tribe, and still able to string together whole sentences. Ain't you the lucky one?
Okay, what do you mean lucky?
You still remember your name? Math? How's your memory? When I came back, there were bits in my memory where all I could recall was a white light and a jumble of voices. Crazy, huh? But you're not drooling, so you're doing okay. The rest weren't so lucky when they got their heads cut open.
Heads cut open? What?
You sure you're feeling okay in there? You might want to check your head for a scar. We all get them after going to that bog. You know, the last part of the ritual. After you pass out, they get a guy to bring you back, cut open your skull, and free your mind. As in, he rips out a bit of your brain. It's supposed to be the part that holds you back, but that doesn't always work out so good. Anyway, you look like a lively one, so welcome to the tribe. My name's Nadine.
My brain! Let's see here. Nadine, your mother asked me to find you.
Look, it's not that I don't want to go home or anything. I mean, I love my ma, even if she does make me want to claw my eyes out sometimes. It's just, I came out here to find a fortune, to make my mark, to be able to bring something with me when I do come back. If you see my mom again, let her know I'll be coming back, eventually, just not quite yet.
All right. See here. Why did you attack the mansion?
Whoa! That was all Jackson's crazy idea. I knew better than to volunteer for that suicide mission. Last time I wandered too close to that mansion, some old ghoul sicked his dogs on me. Screw that.
This Jackson guy sounds like kind of a dick. I don't suppose you know where I can find Jackson.
Off at his magical thinking cave, I guess. We're not allowed to know where it is. He says we're not enlightened enough to understand. I swear that sort of stuff pisses me off so much. I thought joining would be all drugs and magic, but it's just the same crap as everywhere else. Guess that's why I trailed Jackson to his stupid mystery cave.
Oh, really? It doesn't sound like you're having much fun here.
I only been here a week or so, but I'm about ready to ditch this bunch of dummies. I already stole all the punga I could ever need. Hey, if you still want to know where Jackson's hiding, I can help you out. No reason for me to give a damn about this place, you know? His cave's under the cathedral, but it's hard to find. Use this key to get in through a wrecked ship down at the sea cliffs to the east.
Sweet. Oh, well, I gotta go then.
Hey, before you go, if you ever want to get rid of that scar on your head, just come and see me, okay?
I didn't even know I had a scar. Go ahead and pull off. Oh, I actually don't have my helmet equipped right because it's broken. Oh, wow. That is a hell of a scar. They took my hair! Whatever. Gives us character. Devon is probably righteously butthurt about that, but, you know, sometimes you just need a horrific scar to tell you where you are in the world. Alright, so we're just gonna fast travel back down here because time-saving mechanism. Morphine is gone, and I hate everybody. Fuck you, lamppost. My brain meets. See, one thing I do wish is that, like with the withdrawals and stuff, I wish that it would pass if you just didn't use the drug for so long. But alas, not that lucky. Hey there, Broseph.
You infiltrated those tribals yet?
I'm in. Find out where their leader's hiding, too.
And you didn't go track him down and grill him for information. I'm not your daddy. Don't waste your time checking in. Go find him and figure out what he wants with this place, you moron.
Sure.
Back to business.
I still like Desmond. He's an asshole. But he's the kind of asshole that makes you feel like an idiot for doing things that the game developers are kind of, like, not necessarily forcing you into, but that have become tropes. Like where he said, you know, I'm not your babysitter, you don't have to come check in with me, but that's something the game developers make you do because that's what game developers make you do in games like this. I like that. It's almost like he's... Oh, hey! Speaking out against, you know, what game developers do. Ding! That was interesting. Oh no. Oh no. Alright, this is a roamer. One more. Oh, there he goes! Down like a sack of taters. There's probably a reaver over there. Come on. seriously? I'm not missing. The game is just f***ing me. Like, whatever. we don't need to eat. We're not hungry, I guess. Alright, so we're gonna go this way. Go ahead and reload this thing. We are a little thirsty, though. Unless this is not Vampire the Masquerade, I can't drink hobos or something. I'm gonna play that again one of these days. I really liked Bloodlines. Good game. I know everybody supposedly really liked the first one too. Alright, so there's the ship. The temptation is to just flying, leap, and pray. That's what I'm gonna do. Oh, no, shallow. Oh, shallow. Thank you. Not shallow. I'm an idiot, leave me alone. Oh man, those rads. Okay, so is this what I'm looking for? It is. I mean, shotgun. Because I'm sure there are gonna be tribals in here wanting to eat my face off. Or more likely, mire lurks. But hey, yeah, I just saw one over there. There's one in the water. Can't really do much about him. This guy, though, if he would just turn around... And... Oh, I'm terrible. Oh, I'm hitting the fucking rock. That's great, you know, I'm standing like this and it's hitting the rock. I fucking hate that shit. I've bitched about it. I know. It is going to incense me until the day I die. Games having just absolutely terrible hitboxes like that. Oh god, my hit points. Thanks for eventually coming up, Vath. So Fallout 4, I mean, that's still a thing, I guess. I am sure I will be playing it eventually, but don't expect it anytime soon. I mean, this came out in, like, what, 03, 06, 07, somewhere there about. So expect kind of the same delay for Fallout 4. I'm excited about it, don't get me wrong, but I've got so many other games that I just don't think I have time for it. Wow, that is a lot of pre-war money and booze. I want to not accidentally drink the water. Shotgun shells, nice. I'll take it. Thanks, Pirate Pete. You're a lifesaver. Oh, but yeah, so they... Dang it. The Fallout announcements continue. From what I understand, they're, like, getting rid of skills or something. I'm kind of ambivalent about what I think about that. I mean, I know I bitched last time about how Bethesda simplifies all of their games with each new iteration. And it very much appears that that's what they're doing with Fallout 4, but thinking on it, like, jump. Thinking on it, I'm actually, is this irradiated? Oh yeah. Thinking about it, I'm actually not too particularly bothered about it, because in reality, outside of like the weapon skills in this, skills really... Oh, addicted to rags. My god, I am just addicted to everything. Skills in this, you know, like, say, lockpicking, for example. The difference between a 25 and a 49 lockpicking skill is non-existent. It only matters if you hit 50, because then you're able to do the next tier up of locks. So like that, you know, I'm not bothered about losing that. Losing weapon skills and stuff kind of sucks, but... Again, I'm not sure where I stand on that and stuff, so I don't know. It's gonna be a case of, like, I've gotta see what they do.
At last, yes! Desmond will die, and our long struggle will finally end the only way it could have, with me as the victor!
Wait. There's a brain up there. Like, I don't want to just kill this kid.
No, not astral knowledge, you simpleton. Psychic domination. And that still won't be possible until you destroy Desmond's jamming device.
Really?
Desecrate the mansion and remove...
Yes, fine. Go destroy the house and its impurities. Just stop that jammer and I'll be free of you morons once and for all.
Yes. We shall be free of all limitations. Thank you, Master. We shall be the instrument of your mighty will.
To dream!
Whatever. So we've got a killer brain, huh? Oh, it's a holographic projection.
You certainly made quite an entrance. It's a shame about what's his name, but frankly, he would have gotten himself killed eventually. I would have done it myself if I only had arms to throttle him. Now let's hope you're more useful than that one, yes?
What are you?
What you are interacting with is merely a holographic projection, and a rather clumsy one at that, but it's all I can manage at the moment. As for myself, you gaze upon one of America's greatest minds, preserved through the miracles of science! Much more elegant than shambling on as some rotting corpse for all eternity, don't you agree?
Why was Jackson talking to you?
He thinks I'm some sort of god, and I have no reason to disabuse him of the notion. This makes me de facto leader of the tribe, as it were. Regardless, I trust you can be more effective than he has been. I need your help on an important task. There's a troublesome ghoul who lives in Calvert Mansion. I need him destroyed and his jamming device neutralized immediately.
What do you have against the ghoul?
More than you could possibly imagine with your squishy pink mind. But the only pressing matter at the moment is a device in his possession. He has a jammer that limits my projection range to this pathetic cave. Remove that, and I can extend my reach so much further. Killing Desmond would be a nice plus, but I'm sure we can get around to that later.
I have to go now.
Yes, away with you.
Okay. That was certainly not what I was expecting. Workman's coveralls. Yeah, I'm robbing graves. What of it? Well, coffins, anyway. Nothing else, I don't think. Anyways, we're gonna get out of here. And I'm gonna go report to Desmond, because he hired me. Wow, and it's right there at the freaking conveniently placed well. Good to know. Okay, so we're not gonna kill Desmond and we're not gonna disable his jamming device because as I've mentioned in the past, Devon, once he takes a contract, that's who he's working for. Unless the person's like a rapist or something, then he's gonna murder him. But I think Desmond is just an asshole, not, you know, anything crazy. I do wanna talk to him about this though. All right, dick butt.
I knew it. I knew that little bastard was behind all this. After all these years, he's stuck his head out, and this is my chance to cut it off. Figuratively speaking, of course.
Okay, so what is this brain thing?
Him. I should have known. My old rival, so close to his family home. Only he would be so stupid. He was once a man, Professor Calvert. The Calverts owned half of Maryland, back when there was a Maryland to own. Members of the Calvert family were influential all over the world. They practically owned a deed to the U.S. government. In their best days, there were no less than 3 Calvert family senators, 7... They even had a top candidate for president, until that scandal with the dog forced them to drop out of the race. I was particularly proud of that one.
What? Alright, so you know this guy. What's going on here?
Calvert is my old rival. Centuries we've played this game. I knew he'd be stupid enough to hide so close to his family home. It's not a matter of hate. It's a matter of destiny. He is my enemy, and I do not suffer any bastard who opposes me to live. I knew he was here, and it is my intent to find him and call down a righteous fucking hammer on his head. Figurative, I mean. His head.
All right, so you want me to do something else then, right?
Of course I fucking want you to do something else. You don't expect me to trot around this mud hole myself, do you?
All right, you're mean, we get it.
You're goddamn right I am. Now let's get on with the work, shall we?
Alright, what do you want me to do?
So, those half-wits are getting messages from the professor, right? So he's off somewhere, broadcasting to him. But without those buggers to do things for him, he can't do much for himself. So, we cut off his ability to talk to him, and he'll need to try harder. Maybe then I can find this squishy little worm and finish him off for good.
What's your plan then?
If I know Professor Calvert, and I do, he's using a high-frequency cognitive sign broadcast. I have the perfect device to jam up his little talk box. All you need to do is take it to the highest point on the shore and install it. Easy, right?
The big wheel down by the docks, right?
Right. Attach it to the bottom car, then turn it on and spin the jammer to the top. No fucking problem. I'll watch from here and turn it on. Then we'll see where our little professor is. Now, go!
Alright, I was figuring that he was going to send me to the lighthouse, but alright, this works. The Cogwave Jammer! Quick saving. Because we're 20 minutes in and I haven't yet, and I fear this game. Pants exploded. Alright. That's probably for, like, reverse pickpocketing grenade into people's pockets.
It is
pockets.
I, Professor Calvert. Don't bother looking around. I'm in your mind. But aren't you Desmond's faithful little employee? Coming to gum up my work, are we? Well, I have a better idea.
No!
How about instead of playing his game, you destroy that nasty little device? Deposit it in the nearby trash compactor and we will never have to worry about it again.
Yes.
I assure you that the gratitude of Professor Calvert is worth a great deal more than that of a washed-up old limey.
Yes. Install the jammer.
You fool! What have you done? You will pay for this! Pay!
He might be a dick.
No one betrays
me. But you're an
me.
Asshole.
Do you understand? You will suffer for this. You and you. Ghoul both pay.
Oh no! The tribals have found me. Whatever will I do? Ding! And there's another one coming up on my left. With an axe, Seriously?
At last.
Man, she's juking. Oh my gosh. I don't want to waste too much ammo for this thing.
Ow.
You obnoxious chick. Devon, you're freaking terrible. Finger. And reloading. And apparently there's more of them floating around. 32 ammo, another finger. Acceptable. More 32 ammo and another finger. Alright, I see another one on my mini-map.
Sleep forever.
And I hear him talking. But I don't know where they are. I think they might be like glitched into the floor or something. Whoa. Oh! Hey there! Oh! I don't even know what that was, but it was satisfying. I'll take it. Well, in that case, maybe they are up here. But I don't see anyone up there. I'm not gonna go digging around. Okay, we're hurting a little bit. I think I'm gonna pop a stim pack. Just one. Got 20 of them, which is pretty acceptable. This is gonna get annoying. Quick draw, bitch! I fail on that second shot though because I'm terrible. I'm not careful here. Where's my shotgun? Hey there. Woman! For God almighty! My shotgun failed me. I miss my helmet. I gotta get my shit repaired, but like nobody here to repair my shit. Okay, so let's go over to, I guess, this? I don't know. Flip a grenade over there. Talk about hitting. That's never a sound you want to hear.
Dude, no.
Come on.
Oh,
there's another one down. Okay, so there's one up on the roof. Oh, and there's one over there too. Cover. Woo! Okay. Couple more Simpacks and sniper rifle.
Oh!
Well, okay, so apparently that doesn't count as terrain, but I'm sure like right here does because there's a corner there. Whatever, I'm not gonna question Bethesda and their world building. I know. There we go. Okay. Shotgun ammo, and again, another finger. A creeper that I killed ages ago. Yeah, I don't suppose I can just, like, fast travel. Yeah, alright, that's easy. I'll take it. We will probably finish this. Oh my god, my withdrawals. Fuck.